For Soul Glow. Amanda, you wanna let us sing that for us as the show ends?
I don't remember. What is it? Say, you start it.
How about no? How about I'm not gonna do that? I should not have started the joke because now I'm never gonna stop. Just let it shine through.
Oh wait, do we have like 2 seconds? I remember I was supposed to tell you about Activator.
Oh yeah, okay, here we go. What you got?
So what kind of before you had clean head? What kind of hair did you have? Like, did you grow your hair?
That was a nice way of saying before it all went to hell. Before all of that happened, it all got smooth. I had it all. I had curls. I had flat top. I had ball fat.
Did you ever have a droopy curl?
I curled my hair out towards the end. It's probably what expedited the transition to this. But
my dad used to have a Jerry curl, and he had a very wet curl, you know, and he would use Activator, which is what Soul Glow is. I don't know if people know that from the movie Coming to America. Soul Glow is like the fake brand of Activator, which is Jerry curl Activator. And my white mom didn't know how to do my hair when I was a kid, and she was like, well, I remember your dad used to use this stuff, Activator. And all I knew about Activator was Soul Glow, and they left the grease stains on the couch, and I was so embarrassed that she bought it for me. I hid it under the bathroom sink in the very back in case anyone came to my house that they wouldn't know that I had Activator. Because
like, what are you activating right here? What is this about? What is this? What are you?
Like,
I don't want to talk about
power or something. Like,
oh,
what?
My
it's not
god,
not that serious.
But now I'm pretty sure you're all like, don't Activator shame me. Like,
well, listen, I've never tried. It could be the best product ever, and I just refuse to use it on principle because she really traumatized me at like 11 years old, bringing Activator into the house. And I'm like, I'm not doing this. I'm not leaving.
I've had Activator.
All my friends, I lived in like an all-white neighborhood, so I was like, I can't go over to Betty's house and leave a stain on the couch.
Yeah,
like,
I can't be the stereotype. I'm not gonna do it.
Exactly.
I'm not,
that's... I was like, Mom, you can't have me out here looking a fool.
Yeah, yeah. Just wear my baseball cap. No, it was in the 80s. It was when Michael Jackson Thriller and all that stuff came out. I remember my mom's cousin curled my hair out as I had a big old fro. And my mom was so upset. She's like, I didn't want you to do that. And I had it. I was the Jerry curl thing, everything. I thought I was it's the Thriller. Oh man, it was great. But I did that. But then towards the end, I curled my hair out again, but I had that S curl kind of thing, like faded around the side, and curly on the top. I thought I was the man. But then when I noticed that heredity was catching up to me, I just looked in the mirror one day. I said, look, if it's going to happen. So I just took the razors.
I feel like it takes a much bigger man to just go ahead and shave it off than to do the horseshoe for 40 years. Mm. What are we?
Yeah. Right. Exactly.
Yeah. I commend you.
Yeah. Now I can't. I cannot be mistaken anymore. Well, I used to be. I don't know who I was told I looked like back when I was a kid. Now what I get is Malcolm from The Young and the Restless. I don't know if you know that actor. I think he's on the TV.
Oh no! But if I ask my mom, she'll send me 42 photos. Like, oh, you mean this guy?
I know his name.
She's all about her stories.
I gotta look it up. Shamar Moore.
Okay. Wait. I don't know. I can see it.
No. I used to. I don't know. I've only heard two people say that. My great grandmother used to say that to me all the time. And then randomly, one girl said it to me. They said, "You look like Malcolm from The Young and the Restless, like Shamar Moore." I was like, "All right. Okay. That's two. That's confirmed." So now
two is confirmed. Yeah.
I want to be cast as Shamar Moore's little brother in whatever he's doing, because
I was gonna say, if you ever get hard on your luck, you can always go out to what is it, where the Chinese theater is and all that, where they have the impersonators out in Hollywood.
And do my Shamar Moore.
It'll be a very niche thing. Yeah, light, like only certain people will know who you are. Lightweight. But the ones who get Malcolm from Young and the Restless, they'll be like, I can't believe he's here.
Like, that ain't Shamar Moore. That's Shamar Less. So I don't want to face that. Nah, no. What do you think, guys? Do I look like Shamar Moore? Let's put it in the box below. Let us know. Like, that's gonna be so much hate mail coming my way for that. So I should not have opened this door. But so thanks,
I'm
man.
Sorry.
I appreciate it. Making me confess my inner wishes right here. I retract my wish, like on Wonder Woman.
Well, thank you again for having me on. I really had a good time.
Oh no, I appreciate it. It was awesome. It was.
If you like what you saw, make sure to subscribe to the channel and please drop a like on this video. It really does help us. Also, don't forget you can turn on notifications so you don't miss a single review, react, why is that trending, or we got your mail.